Hey everybody, Onepeg here with another news update. Over the last couple of days, there's been some changes, and just like all of these other updates that seem to come in waves, some have almost no effect whatsoever, and others probably will have a little bit more of a meta-level impact. If not economically, then likely physically, depending on the map that you're on. Golden Star, IFAX, and Ibuprofen all saw changes very recently. The first one being the IFAC tactical kit a few days ago was changed to allow for a stopping of heavy bleeds. However, in doing so, it costs 210 hit points or durability, however you want to look at it, of the 300 points available in an IFAC. Now, while this could end up saving your bacon if you kill a raider or something along those lines, it will completely destroy your ability to heal much more of anything else after that usage on the IFAC, so make sure that you're using it when you actually want to. You know what I mean? Secondarily, this morning there was a change to both Golden Star and Ibuprofen. In the case of Golden Star, the duration was reduced to 350 seconds, which used to be 400. The energy penalty on usage of this was changed to minus 15, which is from minus 10, so 5 points of energy worse. And Ibuprofen painkillers, the pill bottle, was changed to a 15 count, and it used to be 12. So a slight buff to Ibuprofen, at least in terms of the counts. The number of uses. The Golden Star itself took a little bit of a hit, and I know that, at least on the Golden Star side, when I posted this on Twitter earlier today, it wasn't met with a whole lot of positivity. There was an awful lot of negativity about this one, and it seems like the player base is kind of begging Nikita to stop nerfing everything that they know and love. But hey man, that's Tarkov, right? A couple of days ago, I reported that there was a change to the MK18, having now been put behind a task wall. And the task associated with it was one where you had to kill Sturman 25 times. It appears now, with the task rewards of what we could see, with the Rubles reward, the MK18 reward itself, the ability to buy it now, and a pro-kill medallion, there was also an unknown part. Well, somebody finished it, and now we have this. The reward is a weapon case. The extra one. The one we couldn't see. Now, I don't know if whether this one actually fits the bill or if it's supposed to be something bigger and better. I know a lot of people were saying this looks like it's one of those tasks where it should have been more of a thick reward, you know? But, hey, at least you get it. And the guys that get access to the MK18, you know, they're not going to be doing nothing. Props to my man Tarotex for sharing that one on Twitter. Appreciate you, man. And now, on to crafting. There's a new craft in the hideout yet again, as of yesterday. This one is for a FLIR. 3 Nixer lenses, 2 Iridium, 1 Vertex, 2 SAS drives, and 1 power bank will yield you a FLIR after a mere 6 hours of production time. So, all the boys can get to thermalizing, I guess. The only issue with this one is that right now, again, much like all of the other new crafts, it doesn't look like it's cost-effective. Things like Iridium and Vertexes especially are astronomically expensive and don't really justify the cost of generating a FLIR. If this were a Reaper, I could see a point because of the high refresh rate, and obviously Reapers are kind of like the go-to for people. The FLIR having a pretty astronomically bad refresh rate associated with it, and the limitations around its zoom and all that other stuff, it doesn't really fit the bill at the moment. But hey, at least you can make yourself the thermal now, I guess, right? For those of us that wished our grenade cases would fit back in our eye cases and or thick eye cases yet again, your wish has been granted. As of now, the grenade box will fit inside of thick eye cases and regular eye cases alike. So there you go. Save more space. Okay, and now on to a whole bunch of map-related changes, most of which you guys probably aren't going to like. On all the maps, Woods, Custom, Shoreline, Reserve, and Factory, there are waves of scavs that spawn. It isn't constant. Like, we don't see, you know, one scav pop up here and there. It's not like a trickle-in kind of effect. Every few minutes, you see a wave. And those waves of scavs are 3 to 5 scavs, usually, is what we end up seeing. Now, this is evident in if you've ever had, say, like a 4-man squad and you go to, like, load into a map altogether as a scav run, and sometimes your buddy doesn't get in, but 2 or 3 of you do. That's because there's this thing called like an upper limit to the number of scavs that can be on a map simultaneously. And if that upper limit is hit, there won't be a scav spawn until after some of them are culled, I guess you could say. Well, that is changing a little bit. In the case of Woods, Customs, and Shoreline, instead of there being like this 3 to 5 scav wave at a time, it's now been modified so that later on those three maps, you're not going to see hardly any of them. It's only going to be a spawn of like 0 to 1. Now, when that kicks in exactly and, you know, the effects and all that stuff, to be honest, the data is a little scuffed. We're not really sure. But what I can tell you is that it's there. So as those larger maps progress, the number of scavs is going to decrease. I'm not exactly sure why they're doing it that way, where, as I guess the load on the server actually becomes reduced, that it's even going to be more, like, further reduced, or if they're just trying to deter people from ratting it out for an entire map and just kind of, like, lying in wait in a bush until they figure everybody's gone and then they can go around and, like, get their scav kills or something. I have no idea what the motivation is. Conversely, on Factory and Reserve, there's going to be less spawns at the start. So on a map like Reserve, where, you know, scavs kind of tend to be a little bit more abundant, you're not going to see them as much at the beginning. It's the same like 0 to 1 scav, like somewhere around the beginning of a map, you're not going to really see them, which I guess allows the PMC players to move around the map a little bit more freely and get set to wherever it is they're going first. I don't know. In Factory, I guess it makes a little bit more sense because Factory is kind of like a more PvP-centric map. So maybe this way, if they're reducing server load at the beginning of Factory, you have the ability to maybe not get netcoded so bad. I think might be the reason. I'm merely speculating, so please don't hold my feet to the fire over that. But anyway, that's what happens. On Interchange, which I haven't mentioned yet, there's been a 7% roughly increase on loot spawns. So you should see a little bit more loot spawning on Interchange. NVG scopes and thermal scopes have now seen their ergonomic penalties increased, thus further nerfing the idea of thermal U being a better U. Also, it seems that the fuel tanks themselves look like they've been also reduced again in their spawn chance. I guess the idea is that BSG, given that they've kind of buffed the generator's ability and how long fuel lasts now, that they're kind of like trying to offset that by making fuel a little bit more rare, forcing you to go to the traders maybe. And last but not least, there's also been a nerf to the spawn rates of the M1A and MK18 338 Lapua rifles. Both of those are decreased. We don't know, again, how much, because the data, again, is a little scuffed, but I can tell you that it has been reduced in the case of those two guns. All right? Sorry to be the bearer of bad news. Please don't kill the messenger, okay? Guys, thank you again for coming by the stream and saying hi. It's been awesome. Looking forward to seeing you all again. We're doing a little bit of practice and some farming for a tournament that I'm in tomorrow with Bams for some duo stuff on evasion.gg's channel. So we're going to be doing a little bit of a streamer duo battle or something. Seeing if we can kill some scav bosses and collect some gear and stuff. Okay? Thank you guys again, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.